Drinking water in many cities across the country is increasingly at risk because of combined sewer system overflows. Impervious surfaces in urban areas like driveways, roadways, sidewalks, and parking lots increase the amount of stormwater runoff entering a city's sewer system. Combined sewer systems direct stormwater and sewage into one pipe. During heavy rains, this sewage can overflow untreated into nearby water bodies. While combined sewer systems are no longer being built in new communities, many older cities in the United States still operate such systems. Researchers at the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency in Cincinnati, Ohio, are testing and evaluating environmentally friendly stormwater management techniques called green infrastructure.
We define green infrastructure as any type of tool or technology we can use to keep water out of the combined sewer system. And that can include rain gardens that soak up stormwater. We can look at cisterns or rain barrels.
Vacant lots are commonplace in Cincinnati. Dr. Shuster is transforming some of them into green spaces.
Rain gardens are a very simple and effective way of infiltrating stormwater runoff and potentially soak up quite a bit of water and function as a sponge of sorts. It consists of basically a shallow bowl in a patch within a vacant lot or a residence, and that bowl accumulates stormwater runoff. The biggest part of all, what puts a garden in rain garden is that a community of plant species that are drought tolerant as well as tolerant to periods of saturation.
Dr. Schuster's research is gaining attention nationwide due to the fact that combined sewer system overflows can place cities in violation of the Clean Water Act. His team is providing guidance to these cities by developing an urban soil assessment protocol that shows communities when and how to use green infrastructure in an economically feasible way.
There is a lot of interest and a lot of pilot testing of green infrastructure around the country now. We're very excited to be a part of that, to exchange information and data and experience. And this goes across academics, goes across other federal agencies that are interested in enhancing the lives of citizens across the country.
EPA scientists like Dr. Shuster are demonstrating innovative techniques that further protect the waters of our nation and public health.